Yo, and everybody, Lambo Calrissian here, and today this is the final video for Cougar that we're gonna have this month, so I figured it'd be a good idea for us to go ahead and tie up any loose ends before we go into the next rider discussion next month. Now bear with me as I go through this because I may not hit the specific loose end you wanted me to tie up. If that's the case and I don't do that, you are more than welcome to give me shit about it in the comments section below. With that out of the way, let's go ahead and get started with the three that I think that we should go ahead and touch up. I mentioned in my Kuga forms and Gurangi video respectively how Kuga and members of the Go group can alter the atomic structure of any item temporarily in order to form a weapon. Now, for reasons I'm mentioning this, it's because Toei practically nerfed this ability for Kuga. Why? Let me explain. Looking outside of the Toku realm, fictional characters like Firestorm, who can rearrange molecular to subatomic structures of any substance into almost anything else, exists. Not to mention Marvel's extremely unnecessarily powerful Molecule Man, whose ability is to control and manipulate the molecules of all matter and energy. You can see how powerful Kuga would have been if his abilities were a lot more vague. If Toei never specifically said he could change things on a molecular level temporarily to make a weapon, he could practically use it in any form, create almost anything he wanted out of anything, and could practically regrow limbs on not just himself, but anyone. Yeah, he could have been way goddamn more ridiculous than he is right now. We kind of see evidence of this where Kuga, well, not really Kuga, but Decade, assuming Kuga's form, battles Kiva in Kiva's AR world in Decade, and he changes the Garuru saber into the Titan sword. Wait, does that mean he killed the Garuru of this time? Oh, shit. Moving on to the next topic, going into Kuga's steed, the Gurum. Kuga's steed, the Garam, is a powerful stag-like entity that was assimilated from various metals as it made its way to Tokyo to find Kuga. In the past, the previous Kuga used it as a horse in combat, while our Kuga used it to become a bard for his bike for many of his rider breaks. It served as being the bard for Kuga's both Tri-Chaser 2000 and his Beat-Chaser 2000. And not only did it serve as aerial transportation, it also had a failsafe. If Kuga ever lost control of his powers while he was in his ultimate form, the Garam would self-destruct into ash. I guess adding more power to power would make it ridiculous, so I'll go away if you're like ridiculous. And the last tie-in I'm going to do is say, in my video about the Arkel, I mentioned that the Lento tribe made it with the help of the Lords. The Kuga character wasn't actually made from the Lento tribe, but was actually borrowed from an incomplete Gurangi. This Gurangi happened to be tied in with Endog of Azebo, which is why the two look alike and both of them had an Amadam. The Lords of Agito, which I promise we'll get to later on in a whole nother section, and future, I promise, are of the Lento tribe. So the possibility of the Heisei era having an amount of continuity there was super ripe. The way it almost kind of went there, and this is just purely my own speculation, is that Kuga could have became the darkness that is very prevalent in Agito's storyline, while Agito was the light. So those two may have almost fought each other. That is mind-blowing. But that's just a theory and opinion on my side. But yeah, I think I'm gonna go ahead and wrap up this video. There's not really like a whole lot of stuff I can say that really reached out to me. These are the three that really like I wanted to make sure I just kind of threw back in there so everybody knows I did have those on my heart. Just didn't need to do some more research on it and figure everything out. But if there's anything I missed or anything you want me to talk about in the foreseeable future, don't hesitate to let me know in the comment section below. Just follow me on Twitter because that's where I kind of put like all my ideas and stuff like that, and I want to reach out to more people there and kind of picks people's brains about what and what, and I can kind of do with my schedule around Twitter so you guys can know when to expect an update and whatnot. Discord was so much fun Sunday, and I want to do more of that, and the game plan is hopefully, you know, with everything working in my schedule and stuff like that, it will be late Friday nights and Sunday, late Sunday mornings, like almost going into noon for a couple of hours. Like we could just use that to do debriefs on like the week so we can talk about stuff that happened in both the most recent Kamen Rider and Super Sentai shows. And we could just talk about whatever, any theories you guys got floating around. I'm always in the Discord. If I'm not doing voice, I'm always in the chat just kind of reading, seeing what you guys are up to and let you know.
Lambo-sama watches. Lambo-sama knows all.
But if you like this video, I would appreciate if you guys gave it a like, hit that sexy subscribe button if you want more weekly Kamen Rider knowledge goodness, and share this video, and don't hesitate to ever hit me up in the comment section and the Twitters and all that other good stuff, man. I love talking to you guys. Like, if you guys were on my Discord Sunday, you guys know I love talking to you guys and just having a good old time. That's pretty much the main reason why I opened up Discord in the first place, so we could just get together and have a good time. Thank you so much for the love and support. Like, you guys don't understand. Like, ah, man, I love you guys like a fat kid loves cake, and I love when you guys support me, and I just want to do better content and do better stuff for you. I'm Lambo Calrissian, reminding you guys to keep calm and toku on.